my topic for the top is not that much serious like the previous guys. It's open source, it's social media presence, core apps muscles. So when I came into IIT Kharagpur, there were two people who influenced my journey into the world of open source. And both of them cleared GSOC in their first years. One of them was Manchu Mishra, the leather jacket guy with the red shirt on, and the other is Pranit Kaua, he's standing outside. So Himanshu was there in my literary society, and the first day we went in for the intro, and he stood up for the intro, and one of the seniors was like, "Do you know who this guy is? He cleared GSOC in his first year." I'm like, "Okay, what is GSOC?" Then I approach him, I'm like, "Hi, Himanshu here, bolo, what is GSOC?" And he tells, "This is Google Summer of Code." Over the next 2 months, I keep pestering him, "Hey, how do I clear GSOC? How do I clear GSOC?" And I never took a step, you know, that positive step towards that direction where I would start contributing. What do I mean? Later that year, one of my batchmates, Pranit, whom I was talking about, cleared GSOC, and then the next year I was like, okay, let's do something. The funny thing is, like, in my first year, I asked around a lot of people, both on Quora, on Facebook, I pestered people, like, tell me, how do I do this? The next year when I decided to start off, I never asked someone any questions. I always Googled it up. So, does social media restrict our ability to, you know, find solutions for our problems? It does help open source grow. For example, if I call Kaua and I ask him, "Hey, what do you think about Quora?" He'll be like, "This is a bullshit platform, people are stupid, this, that." And when KWOC, that's Kharagpur Vendor of Code, was going on this year, so there was a tea stall which is near Azad Hall of Residence. It's known as Super Duper. And Himanshu was standing there. I walk up to him and he's like, "Hey, you wrote an answer on Quora, right?" I'm like, "Yeah." Then he's like, "Okay, so we received 10 to 15 registrations with the reason being given as Samriddhi Bhaiya's answer on Quora made me register on KWOC." So he's like, "Wow." An answer with 3200k views and like 60-70 upvotes was like enough to bring in 10-15 registrations. Imagine if I did that on a larger scale.
So, final update is 120 registrations were because of somebody's answer.
So, basically, how does this entirely work? So, before like Google, Facebook, and like, not Google, sorry, before Facebook, Quora, or you know, other popular, so awkward maybe, GSOC started much before that period and open source existed way back. So how does open source affect like the publicity of these programs? There were certain parallel programs running alongside GSOC. How does it affect the dynamics of these? So there is a popular Quora by the name of Tapeswari Patak, and she has this very popular list which is known as list of SOC programs, Summer of Code programs. These are basically programs which are built on the style of GSOC and sometimes may offer a stipend and may not. So, one second. Okay, this is the list. There's Season of KDE, OWASP, Mozilla Mentor of Security, Outreachy, Railgun Summer of Code, Tor Summer of Privacy, Google Coding, GSOC, SO, Season of, I don't remember software, Open Daylight, XSOC, Data One, Free Software, Red Array, Summer of Haskell, Open FB, Open Mainframe Project, Processing Foundation Fellowship, Segment Open Fellowship, Rare. Now, out of this, if you look at it, KDE is, where's KDE? The Season of KDE is obsolete. XSOC Endless Vacation of Code is obsolete now. And it no longer runs. Like, even if it does, it gets 2 or 3 contributions. If you look at this, like, out of Google, other than Google, these two, you'll look, all of these have independent contributions. Like, what is the source of funding? These are not some big billion-dollar companies. These are open source companies, and like no one's going to put their own money in for you know a project for an open source project. So what happens is basically they put in a PayPal link on their website. Like these companies need to contribute, and why would someone want to contribute to such open source projects? This is a valid question. Like if there's a website, like for example, today I made my own project, Sangeeta LLM. So in that project, if I put up a payment link, will they donate a certain sum of money for my cause? No, they won't. So basically, if you look at this Summer of Haskell, why would someone want to put in money behind Haskell? If they are using it, companies which are using these softwares or you know softwares developed by these organizations would be interested in putting in money behind equivalent of and xstar. The thing behind xstar.org happened, what happened was, xstar.org tried applying for Google Summer of Code because they couldn't find contributors. The last time xstar.org happened, it got just four, it got enough money to, you know, sponsor just four students. So it thought, okay, let me go into GSOC and, you know, that will be an easy task for me. So it went into GSOC and then for 2 years it got accepted. After that, it stopped getting accepted. And hence the end of the, you know, the Summer of Code internship thing for them. Similarly, this year Summer of Haskell. Similarly, this year Summer of Haskell is going to happen, and Summer of Haskell is again applying for Google Summer of Code. And again, like, what is going to happen is basically they're going to get selected. The first year they're going to get two slots. The next year a certain number of slots. The moment they get, like, if they start performing badly in GSOC, what will happen is they won't get accepted the next year. And then neither do they get to do this, neither do they get to, you know, be a part of GSOC. That means an end of the road for them, and also that means a drop in contributions. Okay, so these are the old classical type, SOC style things. What KWOC follows is, okay, a short anecdote on that. So basically when I started, you know, publicizing KWOC, there was a personal thing behind it. My GSOC project was an own project. So basically it was named Sangeeta LLP. Sangeeta is the name of my mother, by the way. And where is Rishabh Madan? He said, I'm objectifying women as a pit installable package. So Sangeeta is the name of my mother, and so that is why I named it like the project after her. So I just worked on Hindi in LLP. I wanted someone else to come forward and work with Bengali. So there was my own self-interest in that, and there is obviously cost where I was a part of. So when I started publicizing, there was one guy who was not from any IIT. And every time I would post somewhere, there was this open source help group where I posted, there was Quora where I posted. And every time I would post there, he would post this Patna Winter of Code, which was organized by IIT Patna. Now, not to sound arrogant or, you know, not to sound like a bully, I got irritated by this. And in one place I commented, when did IIT get established at Patna? And then he's like, it got established this year, he didn't get the part. Then I'm like, there are 31 GSOCers from Kharagpur, how many does Patna have? And he still wanted to argue on that, and that was very funny. So basically, okay, so when I, so basically Kharagpur Winter of Code follows a very logical way of approaching the new style of these seasons of codes. Previously there was this BOSS program.
Bountiful Open Source Summit.
Yeah, there was this BOSS program which used to offer bounties, like, you know, goodies, which was based on, like, their sponsorship wasn't in the sense like their sponsorship was more like endorsement for companies. Like the first position gets a Sennheiser headset. The problem with BOSS was that the number of languages they had was very restricted. They were just based on web technologies. Whereas KWOC allows, you know, a large number of people to come in and float their projects, which also allows a larger diversity of projects as well as languages to come in. Now, the thing that what happens is, like, KWOC focuses on the application period of GSOC. It isn't exactly how the coding period goes, but when you're applying for GSOC, what happens is you are expected to solve a number of issues. So basically, what we do in KWOC is basically that application period part, and that helps prospective applicants with brushing up their GitHub skills as well as contribution skills. Okay, one more. Okay, so basically, the other thing I wanted to reflect on was, this is the end of the slide. So the other thing which I wanted to reflect on was the Quora questions which I usually get. Okay, how many of you have heard of me on Quora, even remotely? Okay. So basically, the first type of questions is, how do I, you know, start contributing to open source? This is the most basic type of question, and this is not just like something which comes as a one-time thing. It comes again and again and again. Once you start contributing to open source, like, if you are an established writer there, that means you are going to get this type of question. The next thing is, like, how do I clear GSOC? How do I apply for GSOC? These are the type of questions. And, you know, answering these types of questions is not going to help anyone. in the long run. There is a standard set answer for, like, okay, I understand, maybe the procedure will change, maybe the application style will change. One answer is enough. But like, asking this question again and again, what happens is like, answering them doesn't make any sense. It's just repetitive things coming over and over again. And majorly what happens is that the applicants keep on asking this and they never start off somewhere. Like with PwC, the experience which I had was, there were 19 people pinging me up, like with Facebook Messenger requests, email IDs and all that. But none of them ever started. The major reason which once I asked an applicant, why don't you start up? He's like, your code base is too long. That isn't an answer. Like, you have to read longer code bases. There's EPE Toolkit, which is an organization in GSOC, which has a humongous code base, and it like you jump from one file to the another in a span of seconds, and then you have to come back to the old file. It's that bad there. So basically, okay, does anyone have any questions regarding like funny instances, etc., etc.?